get your popcorn ready, because this is about to be a good one. Down here in New Orleans, you know we know how to party, and around here we like to say laissez-les bon temps rouler. The wait is over. A sold-out Superdome is the stage.
After a year of partially filled or empty stadiums, this should be absolutely electric.
College football's Snickers national title game has finally arrived, and it is the matchup of our dreams. We have the 13-1 Cougars going against the undefeated Wolves, and this is where legends are made.
Wolves quarterback, the Heisman Trophy winner, LaMarcus James, possibly the best quarterback to come into the NFL since Patrick Mahomes.
And you know who agrees with me on that? Miami, because they're poised to take him number one overall, and I'm hearing for about $35 million guaranteed.
Meanwhile, for the Cougars, you have running back Cecil Burgess, AKA the Haitian Hammer.
He's gonna run for, 200 to 400 yards every game. That's how he set the Big 12 all-time single-season rushing record.
But the people who really build the college football dynasties are the coaches. We are not talking enough about Wolves coach James Lazor.
Everybody knows the guy is an elite program builder, one of the best coaches we've seen, but he has never won the big game.
Monday night is about etching his names in the history books.
You have legacies on the line. You have controversy surrounding the sport as a whole. Monday cannot get here soon enough for the college football national title game.
Helmet with Michigan State's Will Backer. I write simple 68 blast.
Wham.
Darn thing ain't been right since.
Lead.
Hmm?
That's 141 lead.
Pretty sure if
you're on the second level, then you were lead blocking. Michigan State ran Chicago 53 with a robber in the box. I mean, no way you got to the wheel back on the blast.
Hmm? Could have been late. The path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the inequities of the selfish and the tyranny of evil men.
Blessed is he who, in the name of goodwill, shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
For he is his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children.
And I will strike them down with vengeance and furious anger, those who attempt to poison and destroy my brothers. And you will know my name is the Lord, for I lay my fingers upon thee.
You stupid, man.
That was an Oscar-worthy performance.
Shit.
Ah, shit, old Quentin sure can ride him.
Yeah, he can. Damn.
Hey, you turn your location services off?
Yeah, on the iPad too.
We still call this whole thing off. Chalk it up as a research project. Get some grad credits out of it. Hell, I think we'd be halfway to our master's.
Give us the wisdom to see the path we must take, and give us the courage to brave it. Make of us a light. Amen.
You're getting better at that.
Best get a move on them.
Coach can become a hate-seeking missile looking for you.
Yeah. I just hope he understands this ain't about him.
Burgess, able to break away, into the secondary, breaks another tackle.
Right, stop right there, Lukey. Right there. This is what I'm talking about. Simple stretch sweep to 34. Lukey, zoom on 34. Right ankle dominant cut around the left corner. The best running back in the country is turning the corner on an inside ankle lead. Why? 34's left ankle ain't right. It hasn't been since week 10.
Okay, real quick. Cecil scores on this play, right?
Yeah. 80-yard sprint where he outruns a free safety.
Yeah, I guess Vanderbilt, I could outrun the free safety. So here's what we do. If we move Cornelius to the middle, we pinch in the OLBs, we got our safeties thinking run support first. Cornelius will eat his lunch and we will shut 34 down for the night.
All right, I got you.
Boys, Booster Club dinner, 5 minutes.
Yeah, they can wait.
No, they cannot wait. They're the team owners, you're the guest of honor. Luke can babysit the film, right, baby? I tell you what, you can come back here tonight, you guys can touch, and you can watch film all night long. How's that?
72 hours to the national goddamn title game, and I got a parade around in this dog and pony show.
Heavy is the head that wears the crown, my lord.
All right, look, I gotta go get dressed, man. Get ready for this dog and pony show here.
Seriously, you're not gonna back me up here at all?
No, I'm not. I just do your defense. That's your own offense.
Yeah,
that's your life offense
right here.
I made these short and sweet like you like it. I suggest you do the same with your jokes.
My jokes are hilarious and people love them.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Stop. Personal phone. Give me the personal phone. Luke gets the business phone. Give him the business phone.
Anything comes in, you know where to find me.
Well, you need to relax. Let's enjoy the mountaintop.
I'll enjoy the mountaintop when we are at the mountaintop. We're not there yet.
Let's go. Yeah. Please, can we go?
Yes. Okay. Lukey, set all staff for 7 a.m. Bed check on time. On time.
Will do.
Bed check, let's go!
Hey, guys, get in your room, man.
Scotty.
Yo, what up, Orlando? Is Walton in there too?
Yeah, he in the bathroom.
All right, boys, get some rest.
Talk to you later, man. For sure.
Hey, coach, check them back there for me.
Sure. Yo, LJM, it's Scotty. Open up. Come on, guys, stop playing. Open up.
Scotty, I'm already asleep, man. Yeah, Sunday snoring like an ox. You hear him? He broke his nose so many times once it gets on his back, I'm screwed. Yeah, 8 a.m. sprints in the bubble. Got it.
You buy it?
Hell yeah.
Thank God Snickers sponsored this game and not some insurance company. You hungry?
No.
Well, I'm telling you, I know they don't have boosters this good looking in the Big 12. I know the Cougars don't look this good. We have built this program into a juggernaut. 2 consecutive conference championships,
two consecutive playoff berths. And now, for the first time in program history, we are headed to our first national title game. All of you in this room, you have supported, pushed, and prodded, and sometimes much, much worse. But I appreciate it. That's how you grow. And I appreciate the opportunity to have presided over this, to help young men become champions on and off the football field. Go Pack!
You're seriously pressing your bet again? $500,000?
Come on, Roger, you know me. It's for the title. Go big or go home. And I ain't fucking leaving.
Well, the apple sure didn't fall far from the tree with you. God bless your daddy's soul. Old Fred used to like to bet the house in Vegas.
He just liked the free drinks.
What? Here, here.
Question is, how in the glorious hell are we gonna stop Cecil Burgess? Fast as I've seen since Herschel. It's me. I'm flooding the gaps, bringing Mac from the strong side and feeding Cornelius raw meat till kickoff.
Or we breaking his room and Tonya Harding that son of a bitch.
Now, aren't you sweet?
Well, as long as we got LaMarcus back there firing bullets, we'll be fine. Better than fine. Coach, we was just talking about LaMarcus.
LaMarcus who? Well, I tell you what, he was pretty raw when we found him, and obviously he's developed into something really, really special.
You think you can convince him he ain't ready to jump for another year?
I'm just going
to
support whatever's best for LaMarcus.
Amen.
Coach, I got a kid in Little Rock. Hell of an arm. Got to show you some videos of him.
Love to see it.
You remember the bad old days when we were scraping the bottom of the barrel, begging JUCO transfers with cases of Budweiser, jobs at the dealership?
Yeah, all too well.
And all that changed once we got LaMarcus.
Bullshit. All that changed when we got Coach here.
Hey. Coach, Kevin McDonald.
Hi, Kevin.
Director of Communication for the CFP.
Good to meet you. Thanks for everything.
Sure. We may have a situation. LaMarcus just tweeted this earlier tonight. It says he's boycotting the game. Reporters are already swarming. We're trying to keep him off the players' floor. We'll probably do that till morning, but this can get out of hand fast.
It won't. Give me 20 minutes.
Hey.
Hi. A poet at a football game.
Philosopher at a football game. Anyway. You look fantastic.
Scotty, we sure this is the room?
Yeah, Coach.
Okay, and they were here in bed, Jack.
Yeah, they marked off.
What the fuck does that mean, they're marked off? Did somebody see them?
Nah, but I spoke to LJ on the phone.
What the fuck, you ain't see nobody, you marked.
You can't. You don't do bed check on the goddamn telephone. You check the goddamn bed, for Christ's sake. What? Goddamn it. Bailey's got my phone.
You work one.
Yes, thank you. Jesus Christ, man, we're in New Orleans, walking distance to the quarter with LaMarcus James. You might want to actually check that he's in bed at bed.
When the last time did y'all see him? Come on, man. Huh?
When he got off the bus.
Hey, LaMarcus, it's Coach. Just hit me back here on the work cell, okay? If you're out and about, no problem. Just checking in, okay? We'll see you for AM sprints, man. God damn it.
Where's the guy with the key, Coach? Here. I'm sorry.
LaMarcus.
Damn it.
God damn it. Well, I guess we just knock on every goddamn door at the hotel. We gotta find him. Let's go. Go, go, go. Come wake on, everybody
Coach.
Up
if you have to.
Shit.
Come on, Cornelius. Open up the door.
Hey.
Fuck, hold on.
What do you want, Coach?
What the fuck is that smell?
It's Peyton's ass after Popeyes. Is there something you need?
Look, have you seen LaMarcus?
Why the fuck would I know where he's at? What's going on?
Look, it's nothing for you to worry about. Look, man, just be ready for the sprint in the morning. Nasty ass kids.
You're Orlando.
How drunk are you, man?
I had a drink for 4 months. Where's your phone?
In the room, like you asked. But what the fuck is this, LJ?
It's exactly what I said. I ain't playing until they pay us.
What? You broke again? You hurt?
I'm done. Damn, him making billions while the rest of us make scraps? Me and you, we can sell our names. What about everybody else, huh?
Oh, wait. Hold up. So you're going to sit the national title game so some punt coverage Wayne Burnett gets...
A real piece, yeah.
Shit. LJ, you need to think about this, bro. You and Crazy Bible Belt Sunday going to get laughed out the building. And if you're lucky, what? Well, you're going to post some shit on Twitter and the whole fucking machine going to go, okay, we give up. LaMarcus doesn't want to play. Let's just make him happy.
I ain't who you think I am.
So, you ain't the one who gave us all Rona after fucking half the campus during quarantine? You ain't tested with your own piss in 3 years, all your cash going up in smoke or to that shit in years. So you standing on stage for one protest for Instagram and pussy don't make you Malcolm X, brother. Ain't nobody marching in the streets for the number one pick. Look, man. You're a great quarterback. And I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. One of the best I've ever seen. But this shit? You're gonna embarrass yourself, bro.
Look, man, you ain't gotta come with me. All I'm asking is that you don't come out against me.
All right. I'll watch this show as long as you want, but I ain't getting 100 yards from you. Good luck.
Surprises.
I do. I just wish you had a seat next to me at the game.
That's not exactly the reason I came.
Fine by me.
I'm gonna take the job. Get a break from university.
Ron?
Hard to turn down a year teaching abroad.
I just have one little tiny little question, Mr. Poet. What is it, philosopher? What about us?
We're a hotel room romance.
Well, now you're just being a dick.
You know what I'm saying.
Fuck you.
Come visit.
Come visit. Grazie.
Maybe I'm not.
fucking nerves, man.
Just breathe through it. You got this. Fresh as ever.
Baby, this is a long way to Frenchman Street.
Yeah, we like taking in the sights, Ned.
Okay, your money.
Talk now.
Where you want out?
Shit, I'm going back to the farm. You're the one who's got everything to lose.
Glad we heard it up on that.
Keep it running, Ned. We may have to dine and dash.
LaMarcus, Kathy Levy, nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you. This is Evan.
Are you okay?
Peach, yeah, it's just ankle gets a little stiff if I sit too long.
Thanks for agreeing to do this.
Are you kidding? Thanks for calling. Whenever you're ready, if you can go ahead and take a seat for me.
Holy shit.
Man, you look good 10 stories high.
You just had to put that in the background, huh? It was nothing.
Go get him. Wait, wait.
You ready? We're recording.
I'm personally asking all players in Monday's national title game to join me in this protest and resulting boycott in order to demand that the NCAA and its affiliates end their practice of unpaid labor for the majority of their workforce. A practice which results in $18.9 billion a year in total revenue for a system which in turn only spends $3.6 billion on athletic scholarships. Where does the other $15 plus billion go, you ask? Well, I'll tell you, to an extremely lucrative oligarchy. The president of the NCAA received a salary of $3.9 million last year. The commissioners of the top five power conferences receive an average salary of $4 million each year. The latest ESPN contract for TV rights to the college football playoffs is $7.3 billion over the next 12 years. That's over $600 million a year for three games. That's the reason they're expanding the playoffs to 12 games. My coach, James Lazor, receives an annual salary of $5 million, plus up to $1 million in on-the-field bonuses, including the national title game. You see, all of this money is predicated on one underlying principle: free labor. It is un-American, it is exploitative, and it speaks to the darkest spots in the national soul. Now, it is not enough for some of us to be able to use our name and likeness, which, make no mistake, cost them nothing. So our demands are as follows. One, the creation of non-revocable player control trusts for every Division I varsity athlete. Number two, the NCAA will form and contribute to a player's disability pension for Division I athletes who are injured from college athletics.
Shit.
And number three, the NCAA will officially recognize and collectively bargain with the players' union, submitting to all federally mandated laws and guidelines of a unionized workforce. In this, the NCAA will recognize players as employees and not student athletes. Thank you.
He said he'd be right over, so
a lot on his plate.
Hey, there he is. All right. Come on in, Coach. Thanks for coming over so quick. This is Wes Martin from the Big 12. He's going to be our enemy for the next 48 hours. Kevin McDonald from the CFP.
Yesterday.
And Mike Titus, Senior VP Championships, D1 Football.
James, we've actually met.
Yeah, at the Outback Bowl 2 seasons ago.
That's right. You have come a long way.
Looks like you have, too.
Yes, indeed. Please have a seat. Real mess we got here.
Well, not really. I just need to get with LaMarcus and talk things through. These kids don't fully understand what they're doing.
A coach and his quarterback, no closer bond. You were a quarterback yourself back in the day, am I right?
Coaches are just players that can't play anymore.
You still don't know where he is?
What?
Where LaMarcus is.
We're broadcasting this game in 160 countries. They're all tuning in to watch him go against Cecil Burgess.
Boy, I love these marketing guys. You know that LaMarcus and Cecil both play offense, so they won't be facing off.
I know how the game works, Coach.
Yeah. Look, LaMarcus is around. He's probably in the hotel somewhere. I just haven't had a chance to get with him yet.
Coach, I think it's best if the NCAA took the reins here. We're more of an impartial jury. We just want a great game.
Well, I think that's what all of us want, right?
Yes, it is. That's why we were hoping you could shed some light on this young man. LaMarcus, what's his character?
He's a good kid. He's just, like a lot of kids his age, maybe he's a little too fond of the spotlight and its perks.
Well, hell, if I was the best QB in the country, I think I'd be bouncing out of my apartment 3 at a time. Huh?
LaMarcus is not a troublemaker, okay? I want to be very clear on this. LaMarcus is a good person. He's just a kid with too much power who, I don't know, had a bad tweet.
And interview.
Okay, well, you know, Coach is going to right the ship. He just needs a little more time, right?
Yeah.
You think somebody got to him?
Somebody?
Like a organized labor rep, an ACLU lawyer.
Maybe the Russians. That's a fucking joke, guys.
Come on, guys.
Look, LaMarcus, from 6th, 7th grade on, they're big men on campus. He and Emmett, they still think this is playtime here. They don't understand the world stage. They don't understand the implications here.
They just asked to collectively bargain. They want to destroy the student-athlete designation, not the demands of some kids spitting in the wind.
You tell me I don't know my own players?
I'm saying you might be in denial about what is actually happening right now.
Hey, come on, Wes. Straight? That's over the line.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Coach, what they're asking for is bigger than football or one game.
Understood.
It's our entire amateur athletics program in the country. That's 24 sports. For young men and women, gone. Hundreds of thousands of students. Student athletes being denied a college experience.
We're 40-something hours to kick off here, guys. Need to make sure everybody's suiting up.
There hasn't been a single defection from our side. It's theirs that's falling apart.
Oh, hey, nothing's falling apart, okay? Everybody relax a little
bit. Three wide receivers just tweeted, "We're in." With the hashtag that's going viral, fix the system. Your other two stars, Bishop and Cornelius, could be next.
Orlando Bishop is my one and only captain. He is team first. He's not going anywhere. And Cornelius, frankly, can't stand LaMarcus. He wouldn't follow him into the Garden of Eden. He'll play.
One linebacker ain't plugging this hole. You're taking on water fast.
Hey, he got blindsided just like the rest of us, all right? There's no reason to keep attacking him.
Here's an idea. Lean on the sophomores and freshmen who have something to lose. They won't want to risk their eligibility over this.
You'd love that, wouldn't you, Wes? We all know I can't field a competitive team with a bunch of 18-year-olds that haven't played a meaningful snap since high school. Fuck that. I'd rather not field a team at all.
I'm afraid that's not an option.
We wouldn't need any options if I could get with my quarterback instead of sitting around this circle jerk.
Thanks for coming, Coach.
You bet.
Thanks for coming down.
Don't lecture my guy.
Thought you had your conference under control, Everly. We got nothing.
We got time.
Time is the one thing we don't have.
A little bit. We'll be fine.
All right, the Death Star awaits. The Cougars are staying on the 17th floor. There's a stairway around the back.
All right, let's go get this done and get out of here.
Keep it running, Ed. We'll be back in 20.
Eat, nigga. Eat.
Watch this bucket. Nigga, I'm nice. Nice. Watch this bucket right here. Bucket.
Hey, don't fucking cheat.
Hello, Rock.
Emmett Sunday, Esquire.
You may know me for such hits as Last Stand at the Texas Stadium, Destruction at the Peach Bowl.
It's not funny.
I'm number 82.
Yeah, the tight end. What the fuck do you want?
The one and only. You mind if I come in for a second? Thanks, man.
Really? Hold on, bro. You just gonna walk in my room like that?
Hey, so what's going on, man? Emmett Sunday, how you doing? I'm just gonna turn
off. Hey, bro, hold on. Why you turn on my light like that?
Yeah,
wait a minute.
Turn off this TV, man.
Yo, white boy. Chill out and let me know why the fuck you in my room before I fight you.
See, so you mind if I show you something for a second? It may help make my case.
Right,
he's been replying real quick. Hold on. Yeah, there you go.
Hold on. No. This way first. Fuck out of here.
I ain't fucking with you.
Yo, this LeBron, nigga. Look.
That's LeBron.
LeBron DM these fucks.
That's the king.
Oh, shit, he just said what's up to you.
Yeah, he said what's up to you because he knows you're here.
Bro, you know how much I love LeBron. How the fuck you get LeBron to DM you?
Well, we're buddies, man. And I was thinking Clutch just started a new football division to rep. And I was thinking, hell, maybe I just put in a good word for you two. Fly over to L.A., the land of big lips, fake tits, and sunshine.
I love fake titties.
I know, me too. And you sit down with LeBron and Maverick and have a conversation.
We're at lunch with LeBron in L.A. You know I love tacos, nigga. Hold on, how we do that?
It's a little weird. I need your phones.
My phone?
I just need your phone.
Fuck it. Hey, it's LeBron here. Come on, man. Give me your phone.
Come on, Cecil. I ain't gonna do anything weird with it. Come on. And keep my phone as collateral.
Collateral? Shit, I'm gonna pocket this bitch.
Don't move.
Yeah. Yeah. Bro, LeBron. LeBron, though.
What's happening, fellas? Surprise, surprise.
Shit. Not LeBron.
So what's up? I know y'all seen it.
Yeah, we seen it.
What y'all think? Hoping y'all gonna join us.
And skip out on the title game? Man, y'all try fucking mind, for real.
Yeah, probably. It's gonna take a little crazy to get it done though, ain't it?
Yeah, but he's Kuiper's number one back. Going 8 to Baltimore at the latest. He ain't risking that fucking with y'all.
Buffalo should take him at 3.
They're going to tackle.
Maybe Miami gets smart and takes you at 1.
Then where you gonna go?
Me? Shit. CFL after this, probably. Same for Saskatchewan or some shit like that.
Saskatchewan.
Listen, they're still gonna find a way to play this game without me and Emmett. All right, we gonna need you.
The Haitian Hammer running wild on all those TV promos. Come watch you put up 500 yards in a single game. Hell, I go to see it.
Yeah, maybe then he goes number one. But if he sits, they gonna Kaepernick him like you. Come on, bro. He might fall out the first round. Y'all even know what the rookie minimum is down there? Probably not. They taking backs in the 3rd or 4th round nowadays. 4 years and done, we back in the hood.
That is why we gotta stick together on this, fellas.
I mean, think about it.
If we all sit, what are they gonna do? It's called collective action.
The fuck you learn a big word like that?
Intro to organized labor.
A class? You talk about a class. Only class you probably took was intro to organized dick sucking.
Flap your gums because you're scared.
Scared of what? You?
Scared you're gonna be teaching high school PE next year. I know this is my last game, same as you.
Fuck you. I'm playing in the league.
Hey, look, we ain't come here for all that, all right? Look, me and E are serious about this. We just came here to let y'all know. Sleep on it. Pray on it. Look, I appreciate y'all.
Yeah. All right.
No hard feelings.
Yep, no hard feelings.
Collective action.
Man, I hope we get to play those guys. Go ahead, Ned.
We don't get Cecil on board. We're gonna need our whole squad or we ain't playing shit. We get the younger guys, Orlando will come too. Hey, get Bob Reynolds a note. Tell him we'll give him the exclusive.
Copy that. Wonder how many of these we've gone through already.
Accounted for, Scotty?
Yes, sir.
LaMarcus James, for those of you who are not familiar, won the Heisman Trophy this year. Most famous player in college football. picture's 130 feet tall across the street, and now you're telling me what? He's the fucking invisible man?
I mean, we're working with hotel security, coach. I mean, they went out a fire exit without a camera. That's how we lost
him. Well, the media found him, didn't they? I don't know, maybe I should ask LeBron James for help instead of you simple snowflakes who I feed, clothe, and pay six figures a year or get a free top-tier education. This is a fucking manhunt. Find me LaMarcus James and Emmett Sunday, or I swear to God, the next coaching job any of you get within shitting distance of is going to be JV at the fucking Little Sisters of the Poor. Go, get out there. Go fucking find him now.
Find him, coach.
God damn it.
Lead up.
Y'all can hang me all you want. I ain't the one y'all should be hanging. Ain't me cashing out on millions of dollars a year where y'all can't pay rent, can't put gas in y'all whips, if you even have a whip. For 55 years, guys like you ate, drank, fucked, and played ball. We're just happy with a free education, right? Nice free soup. That shit'll keep us happy, right? They know how to get us.
But not no more. Okay? This shit is capitalism at its finest, greed at its worst.
Everybody around us got private jets and private chefs, and we can't even accept a fucking free meal as a gift.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. That pizza slice right there, double fisting with them shits.
They getting kicked out of college twice.
Shit. And we out there every single day, blood, sweat, and tears. You remember your ankle, bro? Hmm? You remember when it swole up like a watermelon? They shot you up and they made you play, didn't they? Huh? Think about how that shit gonna make you feel in 30 years. You ain't got no medical. You got insurance? What you gonna fix your broken body with, huh? Duct tape? Gorilla glue the shits back together? What we gonna do? That's how y'all gotta be thinking about this. Where do we wanna be in 30 years from now? It starts right now. It starts right here.
Who bought all this pizza?
Look, I'll be the first to say it. Lasers taught me a lot about more than just football. But what I began to realize is I was being brainwashed, just like all of y'all. Scared of speaking up because it was easier to go along than get along. Hey, don't let them tell you ain't enough to go around. They got so much money, they don't even know where to put the shits. Y'all okay with that? All right, you okay with that?
Guys, don't think this isn't a two-way street. Where do you green fucks think you're transferring to if I bury your ass on the pond? I own your future.
Where? The hell is LaMarcus?
Let's be real. There are 12,500 draft-eligible players for the NFL every single year, and only 300 of us get drafted. That means over 12,000 of us participate in a multi-billion dollar industry that won't even give us health insurance. And yet they selling us the pearly gates? Zay, you got a resume? Internship? Why not? Because you've been playing D1 football for the last 3 years, right? That's right, and they make you work it like it's a full-time job, don't they? That's right. What about all those bullshit classes they make you take to stay on the field, huh? Hey, you remember the Swahili shit y'all was taking? Swahili? And how do you say, do you want fries with that in Swahili? Guess what, fellas? When y'all get out there in the real world, out there in the jungle, it ain't no fun when you broke as a joke.
Tell us where he's at, I'm taking him back.
He got the W, staying under the fake name.
Okay.
Barack Gambino.
Barack Gambino, man? Seriously?
Thank you.
And even if it means the death of me, y'all can say, I got caught up with that crazy motherfucker and his dreams of glory. And if I can do it, then we can do it, and we can set ourselves up and future generations to come.
I'm about the barn, LJ.
Because there is a barn in Galilee where grain feels so high that they won't even sell it all. And you know what God says? He says, you poor fools, you may think that you're rich, but you are poor in the eyes of God. Why? Because my people are hungry and your barn is full.
Make it plain.
There is a barn in Galilee filled with grain and we out here starving. God is with us. He says there is nothing to lose. There is nothing to fear. I am here and there is nothing to fear.
We got bands and wild.
Come with me.
I plan to, baby.
I mean it. Start a new chapter.
You really want me, babe?
I do.
Got it. Hey, what's your hurry?
Roger.
Brett.
I've been head of the Booster Club since 98. You ever seen a national title game in your own luxury box, Brett?
No.
Lobster, filet mignon, blow, whatever your heart desires.
It sounds awesome.
You want to come with? I can get you a ticket.
Are they even going to play?
Oh, they'll play. Don't you worry your pretty little head about that. You want to find me my quarterback, and it'll be easy street.
$500.
What does that give me, Brett?
A room number.
What time do you get off?
Not mine.
You find us?
A happy accident.
What do you want?
Just talk, that's it. 1 minute and then we're gone. Hey, you look like hell. You okay?
We're owed.
You are owed?
Yes. We're owed.
Taylor, what I think my associate is trying to communicate here is that we're hurting. We feel like we're invested here. Especially after all we've been through together.
Because you loaned me a car?
And helped refinance your mother's mortgage when she fell behind, and also with your brother. Should we talk
about this? Don't! Say another word. And don't do this. You don't give a shit about us. All you give a shit about is your damn game.
Now, Taylor. LaMarcus, what's going on here? Me and you are buddies. You love playing football. Hell, I love watching you play football. An entire college campus, 40,000 kids, thinks that you're Jesus Christ incarnate. What's going on? You need money? Just tell me where to send a check.
What the fuck don't you get? You ever read The Jungle?
What does that got to do with anything, LaMarcus?
The American Dream. This guy Jurgis from Lithuania. He worked at the meatpacking plant in Chicago. Now, Jurgis was young. He was bigger, stronger than the rest of them. So they put him to work in the kill beds. He worked so hard, he couldn't bend his fingers. He couldn't flex his knees. Broke his ankle. After all those years, he just kept on working. And he loved it. See, that didn't mean shit to the guys who owned the plant, though, did it? Because they weren't about to take care of no broke immigrant.
LaMarcus. You ain't that guy. You're about to be the number one pick in the first round of the NFL draft, and Miami is going to pay you $35 million.
Yeah, I know.
That's a whole lot of meat.
What about the guys who ain't going to the league? The guys who busted their head in the dirt for the last 4 years, only to wind up mangled and broke. What about them, huh?
So wait, this whole thing's about you?
It's about everyone, man.
What the fuck do you think you're going to do? You can't square off with the entire system. You two cannot unionize college sports, and that's a fact.
Ain't two.
What?
It ain't just two of us no more. And that's a fact.
We have to dismantle the structure and do something that's more equitable, that's fair for these athletes. I've got teammates that I played, you know, collegiate ball with at Ohio State that suffered some career-ending injuries, some life-altering injuries, that struggle and still struggle today without any support from the university. It's very frustrating. So I'm proud to stand behind LaMarcus James and what he's doing.
Wilson, what do you think of the situation with LaMarcus James?
Listen, Greeny, I'm really impressed by LaMarcus James. I mean, this guy's given up possibly $35 million, maybe the first pick overall. I mean, the reality is he's got so much to lose, but really so much to gain. And I think that you and I both know, Greeny, that this whole system's broke. And we got to fix it. It's got to get fixed immediately.
There you have it. Directly from one of the great quarterbacks in the history of the NFL, Russell Wilson. He won the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award in 2020. Russell, thank you.
Always a pleasure, Greeny. I'll see you soon.
In the meantime, we've got other news to talk about today.
I understand. You know, we all know what's at stake here. I will get him into this game. You have my personal guarantee. Of course. Well, thank you. Yeah, he hung up on me. You're up early. What, do you sleep in that power suit?
Well, might as well at this point, right? Pressure from the overlords?
I'd say my very early retirement is being discussed. Unless I change the optics and quick. And if I go, so goes your retainer.
Well, we can't let that happen now, can we?
We offer talks. We hear their demands. We promise a committee to explore.
No. They've got 40 players now.
I heard.
They think they can win this. If we offer talks, then they will never leave the table empty-handed.
They're kids.
Exactly. They haven't lost enough to believe that that's the most likely outcome. They don't understand that life is about losing.
I pay you for options. What are they?
Well, I can only see two. You either give them what they want.
Second option?
We savage them. You find everything, every grain, every person. You turn LaMarcus James into a monster that no one could follow. LaMarcus decided to do this. He waded into your waters. We have to react.
Unfortunately, I don't have the luxury to react, Miss Poe. But you do.
It started.
Where?
They got their hounds loose. They're gonna dig up more. We're gonna have to move again.
No more running. Let him cut.
Luke! Yes, every player. I don't care. Luke! On the goddamn roof for all I care. 30 minutes. Bailey, have you seen Luke? I got 9 players and a cabal of fucking idiocy around me.
I sent him to the store for McConnell's ice cream.
Bailey, you can't be doing that now. This is fucking serious. LaMarcus. God damn it.
You know what hurts the most? He never came to me with any of this. After everything we've been through together. Are you... fucking Christ, are you fucking kidding me? Now? I got a full-on rebellion in my locker room. I got the head of the NCAA and both conferences up my ass at the national fucking title game. Now you're gonna...
Coach, we talked about this. How can I say this again in a way that you can get it? I need to find myself again. I need some me time, not you time.
God
me
damn,
time.
You fucking selfish.
Wow, finish it. Finish it.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I know the sacrifices you've made for me. Of course I do, but please. Okay, which place do you want me to stay away from? Where are you going, the beach house?
I'm going to Rome.
Rome. Okay, well, I could stay away from Rome. You're not going to Rome alone, are you?
Question. If I hadn't stayed here, explain to you that I was leaving. You've noticed I'd gone?
I know, I get it, I get it.
Oh, I want to know.
I know, it, look. It's this fucking job.
Oh, God.
Babe, I swear to God, I will make it up to you. Okay? Please. I swear to God, I'm going to make this up to you. It's just...
James.
We just got to get past this game. Please.
James.
Babe, I need you here with me now. Please.
Coach, he's in the back. Can you please? Thank you.
Sure,
excuse me, I'm sorry.
Sure. Good to meet you. Coach? Coach Laser? Morning, Coach. Catherine Poe. You met earlier? Is now okay, sir? It's kind of urgent. Everything all right? Well, if there's anything I can do.
What do you want?
You have a rebellion on your hands, sir.
What exactly do you do? You're with the NCAA?
I'm not. I'm outside counsel.
And your name again? I'm
Catherine.
Sorry. Catherine, would you mind just fucking off back to your C-suite?
This is a private physical LaMarcus had. It's from July for an insurance policy.
How did you get that?
It's a firm specializing in medical data acquisition. And this is an MRI of LaMarcus's left knee, which unfortunately has no cartilage. He's been hiding it for 5 months. His body is a ticking time bomb. It's only a matter of time before that knee gives out on him. He is never going to be the number one pick, not after the combine and physical. He'd be lucky if he got to go day two. And he's known that for some time.
I haven't seen nothing to indicate he's got a bad knee.
He's 21. He could eat gunpowder and then go run a marathon. Now look, it's best if this comes from you. How disappointed you were to learn that he's been hiding this. Maybe in retrospect, you did notice a limp during practice.
Come on now, what exactly are you saying?
5 months ago, LaMarcus figured out he is not going to be the number one pick, and he is trying to cash in now before the teller, yes,
bullshit,
sir, before the teller window
LaMarcus
closes for
him.
This is a shakedown, sir. Pure and simple. He is trying to recoup his losses, and he is going to take everything that you and your players have worked for. Let me ask you, sir, how does a D3 quarterback with a noodle for an arm who runs a 5-flat-40 time, how does a guy like that become the head coach of not one but two D1 powerhouses? Because that guy is a winner. And this is your time to finally capture that national title. Do not let LaMarcus rob you of your legacy. Now, we will leak this to the smaller sites. You will do a presser for the networks, and the aggregators will take it from there. I have some remarks if you want to take
no,
a look at.
No, thank you. I don't need your fucking remarks. This is my football team. They will play for me.
Coach, wake up before you don't even have a team.
I know right now, you think life is always going to be like this. You're at the center of everything. Alive. And greatness is right there, within reach. But that's not true. This may very well be your only fleeting moment at the top of the mountain. Look at me. I'm 60 years old. I look like I'm 80. I feel like I'm 100. I got a wife that hates me. But she just left, actually. I got a cock that doesn't work without a fucking pill. My best buddy, since we were little knuckleheads playing pee-wee football. My best friend, Clint, just died of blood cancer. Just like that. 40 years ago, I was you. I was you, man. Magnificent. Quarterback of my little college in North Dakota. I had dreams, and I had the energy to chase them. And now, I got one thing left. One thing in my life that means a damn to me. You men. This room. This is all I got. And that's okay. Believe me, this is all I need. Now, some of you are looking at me like, well, bullshit, coach. Come on now. You got money. You're fucking rich. Yeah, I got money I couldn't even conceive of when I was you men. Believe me when I tell you this. Money is shit. Money is a numbers game played by people in $5,000 suits in New York City offices for their own benefit. There is no glory in money. No life-altering challenge in money. There is no confrontation with your deepest fears and therefore your greatness in fucking money. Oh my God, what I wouldn't give to be you men right now. One day away from glorious battle alongside your band of brothers, in front of 100 million people all over the world. Glory.
the greatest glory you are ever gonna feel. Do you wanna give that up?
For those of you who were thinking about boycotting, you've made your point. They are gonna have to change. Because they heard you. They are scared shitless. It's beautiful. It's fucking hilarious. Change is coming. Meaningful change. Trust me on that. Every one of you has worked your whole fucking life for this moment. Don't rob yourselves of your destiny. Glory is at hand. Glory is yours. Glory is ours. Glory! Take it.
That was a great speech. Now let's prove to them that LaMarcus is only doing this for his own benefit. So you have enough players not only to play this thing, but to win. You need a minute, Coach? You need to collect yourself. Okay.
Let's get it over with.
Miner's breakfast.
Breakfast of champions.
I'll tell you, ice in his veins. Now, I understand we have some late breaking news. Yes, we're going to a live press conference with Wolves head coach James Lazor.
Well, I had noticed a slight limp after week three, but I just chalked it up to, you know, the usual bumps and bruises. So I was disappointed when I found out that he'd been concealing something more serious.
I can't believe Coach is doing this.
Do you think he concealed his injury to protect his draft status?
I don't know. He's gonna have to pass some very thorough physicals before the draft, so I don't
know. I found that MRI quick. Their man's good.
Do you feel he was manipulating his teammates to cash in on the national title game?
I guess you'd have to ask his teammates that.
Coach, do you feel
that this is a further example of a form of modern-day slave trade?
I'm sorry, I guess I don't understand that question.
The physical. Like inspecting a slave's teeth to determine the price, only now it's his knees.
Well, if you call getting a free top-tier education and 4 years of first-class accommodations and nutrition, not to mention a sizable living stipend, and then toss in a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to play in a national title game, if we're calling that the slave trade, then I'd love to be a slave.
That's the last question.
Well, that already went viral.
Call Greeny. Tell him we're going live. Let's blast it all over Twitter, too.
I am joined now by LaMarcus James, who won this year's Heisman Trophy and has now rocked the entire world of sports and well beyond with his boycott of the national title game, which is scheduled for tomorrow in New Orleans. LaMarcus, I'm going to jump right into the question everyone is asking. Are you boycotting this game and demanding compensation because of an unfortunate medical condition that could jeopardize your status in the draft?
Good morning, Greeny. The answer is no, unequivocally, no. I have no cartilage in my left knee. It'll degenerate over time, maybe 8 years, maybe 20. But name me an NFL team that wouldn't take 8 to 20 years of elite quarterback play. You see, the reality is this isn't about me. This is about our current system. This is about my fellow D1 athletes and teammates who have fallen victim to, quite frankly, a plantation mentality.
I want to talk about that mentality.
That's fucking rich.
Because clearly that is at the center of this entire conversation. Your coach, just today, said this is a system he'd love to be a part of and even invoked the tragic word slavery. I have to ask you, do you feel this is a slave trade of a different kind?
Can I give you another comparison, Greeny?
Yeah, of course.
This is the home of my best friend and teammate, Emmett Sunday. Emmett's father is a farmer outside Lincoln, Nebraska, and his mother is a teacher's assistant. Now, they've saved up a little bit for retirement, but mostly they just live month to month. One swollen appendix, one turned ankle from insolvency. Now, their son, Emmett Sunday, has been a four-year starter for one of the best college programs in the country. Tomorrow, he'll play in a game that'll gross over $500 million. $500 million for a single game, and Emmett won't see a dime. His football days will be over. Zero compensation, zero medical insurance for all the injuries he sustained, some of them permanent. And now this is the Palm Beach vacation home for my coach, James Lazor. This is his Chicago penthouse. This is his six-bedroom Craftsman where he stays during the season, his work home. Now, Coach has profited off a system that is entirely based on free labor. We're not playing in any games until those who actually play, and not just the superstars, I mean all athletes, down to the special teams,
Jesus,
are considered and compensated. Now.
This crazy motherfucker.
There you have it, directly from LaMarcus James. LaMarcus, thank you very much. I appreciate the time. We'll take a short break. We're back with more in just a moment.
What the calamitous fuck? We've been goddamn outflanked by two kids, like we're in Scooby fucking Doo. Oh, you know what the dipshit sidekick did when LaMarcus was grandstanding on TV?
Sunday.
Huh?
His name is Emmett Sunday.
Oh, thank God we got that all cleared up. Emmett fucking a sideways Sunday leaks my Nike contract. Now every New York City zigzag's asking me where $30 million a year goes.
Where does it go?
How the hell do I know?
And you're the head of the conference.
Excuse me?
You're the head of your conference. You should be able to answer a layup like where your sneaker money goes.
Okay. Band fields. Softball stadiums. Turquoise green Bermuda fucking sod. Where else?
Orlando Bishop just tweeted this.
He's out. That's cute.
We got four players threatening to walk now, too.
How the hell are these two even doing this?
I still think Coach Lazor's the one to talk LaMarcus off this ledge. He walks him back, they'll all follow. Where's your coach now?
He's, taking a minute.
He's tanking.
He's fine.
What does he need?
A divorce lawyer.
He's fine, I said.
Lazor or no Lazor, we're putting two teams on the field tomorrow. Even if we gotta dress the damn cheerleaders. Who's second in line if Lazor can't go?
I guess, Ronnie Dunn, defensive coordinator.
You trust him?
Yeah, company man. Been at the university since player himself, so yeah, he'll take marching orders.
You sure?
This a fucking inquisition?
I don't trust anyone with a vested pension and Medicare.
Oh, God, you know what? Fuck you very much. All right? I need this shit like I need a third tit. I will march my entire conference right out that door. Put together my own playoffs without any of you. How you like me?
You'd be in breach of 16 different contracts. Squander $100 million payday for tomorrow alone. Not to mention what I imagine would be a full audit of SEC expenses under your tenure, you know, to make sure that those band field softball stadiums and turquoise green Bermuda sod weren't really just high-paid escorts in New York City at the Bellman Bar of the Carlisle. Bouncing them out of your apartment three at a time, right?
Fuck you.
We're still 24 hours away from the Snickers national title game. Only the biggest
game. Man, these guys are already getting free education. Money's just gonna ruin it. They're ready for all that money. I wasn't when I was 18.
I don't know if this man is a racist, but what I do know is that he made a fortune mostly off the backs of young black men.
Question. If I hadn't stayed here to explain to you that I was leaving, would you have noticed I'd gone?
Sorry, buddy. It's really not a good time, okay?
No picture.
Have a good game, coach.
I know for a fact that LaMarcus and the guys, they respect the hell out of you. And you would be the first African-American head coach to lead a team onto the field for a national title game. Hell, hopefully win the thing, huh? Let's make history together.
May have started with this imaginary pie in the sky idea that it was about amateurism. And at one point it was. But then there was a turn and it became about money, plain and simple. And I thought this was America. I thought this was capitalism. You're allowed to make money off your own specialized talent. What happened to that? Why is it a different?
Y'all by your lonesome?
Just me.
Coach, you two are really hard to find. It's easy to find Bigfoot than to find you two. Look, relax. I won't tell Laser. You know something? I can't give credit to you two, actually. I'm really surprised you was able to pull this off. But you got trouble. Yep, they still gonna play the game.
A 19 freshman? Cornelius?
Hey, I don't care who plays as long as it's on TV.
The shit bowl.
Shoot, they shitting their pants right now. In fact, they got so desperate when they approached me instead of, if Laser doesn't show up, I can bring the team out to the field.
So coach is in?
I don't know, man. It's really hard to tell right now, but it looks like it.
Damn. So what you gonna do? First black head coach in the national title game? It's a big deal.
I ain't no fucking pawn. Hell no, I'm not doing it. I'm one of the best official coaches in this country. I don't need no fucking handouts.
Amen, coach. I mean, we feel the same way. Even if this whole thing goes up in a ball of flames, we're not stepping on that field.
Look, y'all, have I ever tell you the Hannibal Lawson story?
Who?
Hannibal Lawson. So Han Lawson, to me, was one of the best defensive tackles in Louisiana high school history. He went on to LSU, you know, a bright future. Got his knee shredded in practice. And the result of that, they took his scholarship away. But Hannibal did something interesting, right? He hired a lawyer in a cheap suit with some night school degree, and he sued the NCAA for workman's comp. Smart, right?
Yeah.
Went all the way to Louisiana Supreme Court.
What happened?
Student athlete.
Yeah, they say he was nothing but a student athlete. They didn't consider him an employee, even though they were selling hundreds and thousands of tickets every fucking Saturday, making millions of dollars. You're breaking your body every fucking practice and every game. And whenever they decide to take the scholarship away from you, they can whenever the fuck they feel like it. That's a crazy, sick system. Maybe you two will change it. I don't know. But I want y'all to understand something. It's a lot of Ham Lawsons out here.
Survival of the fittest.
America. This little pigskin football right here holds a lot of weight to it. It's more than a game. It's a fucking business.
Hey, coach. Thank you.
Good luck, fellas.
We're gonna need Cecil on board. We both don't play, the advertisers will start pulling out. It's the only way.
Take a little more of the edge off. Gotta let it out. If you don't, it just stays inside you, becomes poison. Okay, what's the plan?
Damn it.
I can't even focus on that right now.
Well, you got to. You got to bifurcate.
I don't know what that means, but I think I get the gist of it.
About to lose $500,000 because of LaMarcus.
Taylor.
He fucked us.
Put the phone down.
He fucked us.
Put the phone down. Coach, I know you don't want to hear this right now. I've been married 3 times myself. But the hurt goes away. Poof. One day, just like that. Gone.
I'm telling you, Bailey's my one and only.
Well.
And she's gone. And it's my own goddamn fault.
Coach, no offense at all. You love life, that's your thing. Your racial views, that's your thing. But we have a national title in less than 24 hours. We need to focus on that. Can you please just
fucking
focus on that?
Fucking racial views, first of all, one goddamn reporter based me into saying something stupid.
I know
stupid.
You're not racist. I'm just saying we got the game to focus on, okay?
What fucking game? I don't have a
less
goddamn team.
Hours.
I'm supposed to walk out of that tunnel with freshmen and
nobody's
go in there
you,
and get our ass kicked.
Nobody's asking
you. You got to figure it out.
That's not competition. That's a fucking slaughter.
You got to figure it out.
I'm doing what I can.
You got to do better, Coach. You're on a contract.
Come fuck that contract. Are you talking to me about the fucking contract right now? I can walk across the street tomorrow and get another contract if they find me in breach. I don't give a shit.
Coach,
I don't need the goddamn money anyway.
Coach, you're hurting right now. Let's just give it an hour or two. See the state of play. It's best not to make any decisions feeling this way. I tell you what, it's the ones that are closest to us that hurt us the most. You as good as they say you are?
To which of my many talents are you referring?
There was a fight that no one knows about. A real brawl. The kid got hurt. Bad.
I'll alert the authorities.
Oh, they know. He's blind in one eye now and got a hole in his skull. But money talks, and NDAs don't.
I'm listening.
LaMarcus.
Ciao, mi piaccio. Oh, crap, I think I just called you my pistachio. Your phone sucks. Is mine in there?
It is here. I just got a text from a guy named Mike Titus.
What? Oh, crap, I just must have grabbed James' personal again by accident. Can you bring it to me, mi pistachio? Probably going apeshit right now. After everything we've done for LaMarcus, every single one of those kids are spoiled brats. Spoiled freaking brats. Jeez. Oh, I cannot wait to go to Rome. There's this one place that I want to eat at, and they still have the bullet holes in the walls from the war. Do you see this? Do you see this? Probably not, because your phone stinks.
I've been helping LaMarcus.
What?
You know, with his boycott. That's why I'm here.
I don't get it.
He came to me after class. And what was I gonna do? Be another tenured paper tiger? Teaching organized labor 5 days a week, then hide behind my desk when one of my own students actually wants to do something about it. So, I helped him with his strategy. Anyway, I could. It's funny, LaMarcus knew the rumors about us, like everybody else, except your husband, of course. And you, calling LaMarcus a spoiled brat. Especially when he has so much to lose. Maybe you're more part of the system than you think.
Get out. Get the fuck out of here. Leave!
Sorry, I think we got the wrong room.
No, this room is Cecil's. Come in, we don't have a lot of time. My name's Catherine Poe. I come bearing gifts. You need my phone? Look rough.
Just a call. Where's Cecil?
They're in a suite 10 floors up playing 2K. No, wait. You haven't even heard my offer yet. It's a pretty good offer. You know, a lot of wonderful things and a lot of meat on the bone.
Okay. What you got?
I send the best concierge doctor in New Orleans, Dr. Eric, to your room. He gives you an IV, a Z-Pack, you get plenty of rest. You and your team play the game, and you go number one overall in April. All your dreams come true.
And?
I will personally make sure that the NCAA forms an exploratory committee to fully monetize amateur athletics.
Exploratory committee?
Yeah, that's gonna be a pass.
No, wait. You haven't heard the cherry on top. The best part is you don't go to jail.
For boycotting a football game?
For the attempted murder of Casey Walton.
Wow. Wow! For the last 48 hours, you guys have been trying to destroy this man. And what, you land on outright assassination? For what, money?
Casey Walton is blind in one eye. He has a crack in his skull, and he hasn't walked the same ever since that fight outside of the gin mill bar and grill. So I spoke to his mother, and she jumped at the idea It's not bullshit. She jumped at the idea of being able to throw out that NDA and burn that 100K that was used to buy them off. If it meant that she could find the guys who hurt her son and get paid again.
You don't know what you're doing.
No. She ain't got nothing. Let's get out of here.
I got Reggie. Your half brother.
So you spoke to him?
Haven't found him yet. When I do, I promise you, I am going to piece together what exactly happened that night. LaMarcus, wake up. How do you think it is gonna look when someone like Reggie, who has two felony possession charges and assault and battery, shows up in front of an all-white jury in Missouri with attempted murder charges to a guy who is permanently injured? One look at that, Jack, and I'd be able to know that he was the one that kicked Casey's ass. But guess what? This is America. Nobody cares about your brother. Nobody. The only one they were able to spot that night in that melee was one, LaMarcus James, star quarterback. And so the state police picked you up and hit you with charges, but some deep-pocketed booster who I think I just fucking met stepped in and paid off Casey and his family. Because that's what we do in big football, right? We protect the phenom when he has a chance of bringing home that national title this year. Sound about right? I suggest you let Dr. Eric patch you up tonight. And then we do a joint press conference in the morning. All the head honchos up in the penthouse, heads bowed, agreeing that yes, there is a problem. And then you play, you win, and you get to take that victory lap you have been dreaming about since you stood on the sidelines watching your big brother in North Virginia. And then change does come because of you, eventually. And that is something you both can be proud of.
I got a question.
Are you completely fucking heartless, or just a little bit?
Oh my God.
How do you live with yourself? Honestly, how do you live with yourself?
I am not heartless! You do not know me! You think I don't know your struggle? You think I don't know what you have come from? that I haven't been there? You think I don't know what it's like to be without heat in your house? That I don't know what it's like to not be able to afford your jersey and you are avoiding your coach because you don't have the $50 to pay for it? I ran track at Duke, okay? Full ride. No big medals, no big wins, but I took that money because it was the only way I was gonna run myself out of that Red Hook project. You think you know me? You don't know me. I had to fight and climb and crawl to be here because I did the work. The NCAA spends $3.6 billion on student athlete scholarships for kids like me, like you and like you, so that we can get a leg up. And what happens to all of that when they start paying you? What happens to volleyball in Minnesota, to soccer in Idaho, to softball in South Carolina? What happens to all of those other sports that are not men's football and basketball? You out here fighting and you forgot who you're fighting for. You know, but... Hey, what do I know? I'm heartless.
And good morning from the Big Easy. I'm Steve Levy. We are some 12 hours away from tonight's Snickers national title game. Now, I'm being told that a midnight deal may have been brokered with LaMarcus James. Details still remain a little bit sketchy, but there's a news conference scheduled for a couple hours from now. My sources tell me that both teams could be at full strength tonight, and that includes James. You know what else that means? Strike up the band. Fire up that old grill. We're gonna have some great football action for you.
The 13-1 Cougars against the undefeated Wolves, the two best players in the country, or will it? Even with the rumors of a late night deal with LaMarcus James, many odds makers still doubt he will actually play tonight. So the question is, can James Lazor's Wolves win without their star quarterback? I'm not so sure.
Well, yeah, he and LaMarcus have the same mother. You know, they both grew up in Virginia. Reggie, he played JUCO football, but that fizzled out after they cut him for having too many concussions. I would start with the state prisons. I mean, even try mental health facilities. We need to do a social media backdoor too. You know, I doubt that he even has an account, but we have got to find him. He is our pressure point. Oh, coach. I got your message.
This thing we're toying with, it's Pandora's box, you know?
I know.
Nobody gets hurt. Nobody goes to jail. We just play this game.
That's what we all want.
Dear Lord, trees are thick, and we've yet to see a path through the wilderness. Send us a light. Show us the way. Amen.
Amen. I can't believe you've been here this whole time and didn't tell us.
What? You thought I was gonna miss the show?
I'm sorry.
Oh, hey, you don't owe me anything. You're the one, the two of you, who had the guts and the vision.
I meant about her.
Oh. Yeah, her. Well, I made my own bet on that one, so.
Thou shalt not commit adultery is the seventh commandment.
Thank you for clarifying that, Emmett.
You're welcome.
Look, Elliot, we can't thank you enough, man. Without you, we wouldn't have even had a shot to pull this off.
What's going on here? Are we about to hold hands and feel good about your little protest? Because I thought you guys were in it to win it. You know, as if it were, say, the national title. Let me give you a little something I stumbled across from my travels. I believe that's your coach's. Wasn't even wrapped in aluminum. Amateur move.
Yeah, but what's the point of this? We can't unlock it.
Do you need to? You know what's on it. And you're a quarterback. You know how to bluff the other team.
So you're saying we keep going?
That's not my decision. It's not even about which one is right. It's about which one are you going to be able to live with, no matter how it goes, how much you suffer the consequences. I'm just letting you know, you still have some options. It's off to Rome for me, comrades.
What, you interested for the game?
Yeah, I hope you hit for the masses. It's like too much winning for my taste. I'm so proud of you guys. You did this. You alone. And it was fucking magnificent.
Lenny. God damn.
Well, we're about due for our surrender. What you thinking?
I don't fucking know. My head is pounding. Where's that dog?
Yeah, I'll go get him. He said he'd wait in the lobby. Damn, you sick. Let's see if I can get you another IV. I'll be back in 10.
As soon as he gets here, we'll have the coach and him reunite, pleasantries, and then we'll get right to inviting the media in. I'll give them a few minutes. They'll go off to play. I'll remain time. Here we go.
Hey, LaMarcus has risen.
There he is.
All right. All right.
Great to see you.
Can I get you something, some water, Snickers?
I'm good, thanks.
You were a little under the weather, but you're better now.
Yeah.
That's good news.
Not for us.
True.
I just wanted to get us to have a little face-to-face before we bring the cameras in here. I was just telling the coach here how impressed I was with your conduct. Very honorable.
LaMarcus, the team is back. They heard about this deal, and everybody else is playing. It's just you and Emmett now. These gentlemen are giving you a committee, and they are going to address all of your grievances. So,
Time to put on those pads. Join your brothers and do battle. Everybody's counting on you. I'm counting on you.
You know, I assure you, LaMarcus, this isn't a ceremonial committee. We're gonna dig down into these issues and figure out what's best for all of us. All right. Like the coach said, we have a game to play. Let's get the cameras in.
I didn't say yes.
What's that?
I didn't say yes.
What would it take in your mind to get to yes?
Well, our demands haven't changed.
Sealed case file from that fateful night at the gin mill. The detectives investigated for 2 weeks, and then suddenly Casey Walton decided to drop the charges. A lot of moving pieces in there, Marcus. This thing is a minefield.
You find my brother yet?
Getting close. I'd really love to stop the search and just have a beer. Watch a football game.
Well, why don't we tell him, Coach? We're a wolf pack, right? We hunt together, we starve alone. Ain't that the creed you always preach? Why don't we tell everybody how high up this really goes?
Stop. Just stop. Look, you come out of this now. You're not just a Heisman Trophy winner, NFL first rounder. You're an icon now. You've already accomplished that. You're the Curt Flood of collegiate athletics. You're making history here already. They're gonna write books about you. But don't throw everything away for whatever this self-righteous bullshit is. Come on, man. You've worked too hard. We've worked too hard. For this. Let's just go fucking win this thing. Win.
That's all that really matters, right? Just win. So that's what I did. I won every damn game I could. Conference championships, Heisman Trophy, I won and I won and I won. Until you were so blind, you didn't even see the game I was really playing. You see, in order to slay Goliath, you gotta do it on the biggest stage with the brightest lights. Millions of people, an entire system, so desperate for one more win. They do anything, give anything, no matter how many bodies we gotta stand on top of. And then you got your professor, who's fucking the coach's wife, to give you everything you need. And you win.
Motherfucker! God damn you! You fucking ungrateful! Jesus fucking Christ, LaMarcus! My wife! My wife! Jesus Christ, man. Everything we've been through together. Everything I've done for you. You were a pimply-faced little 16-year-old boy. Scared to leave home. And I looked your mother in the eyes. And I said, I will take care of your boy. And that's what I've done. Treated you like my own.
like my own son. How could you? God damn it, Marcus. Why?
All the ones to come, Coach. The ones winning is fortunate. Get this broken system unbroken. So no more of us get banged up and forced back into poverty. Just like what happened to Reggie. You're the only one who knew about that fire. You stoop even low and you bring Reggie into this. But to you, he's just some pawn that you can use against me? He was my brother. He was a human being. Reggie died 4 months ago in Tallahassee. He took his own life. Y'all didn't know him. What's worse, y'all don't even care. There's always some new batch of kids and get you more wins and get you more money. I am not your son. I'm a man.
Yeah, you are. And I love you. But I got a football game to win.
Gentlemen, would you step out for a minute? Give us some time.
You open up that minefield, it's gonna be more than just me and Reggie. Coach's phone, we got emails from prosecutors, law enforcement. All of them were involved in the cover-up. Shoot, even the governor. Chest bumps in the locker room on game day. Coach's phone, you'll find a text where he promises to take care of it.
The martyr. Willing to die for the cause. I find that courageous, admirable. But what about Emmett Sunday? You said you were doing this for him. Miss Poe?
It was chaos. People everywhere. Then all of a sudden, LaMarcus James, the quarterback, showed up. With someone else. A big guy was really dangerous. And then the big white guy flew through the crowd and hit one guy who dropped like he was dead and threw another guy into a wall. Marcus grabbed the man the crew were beating on and everyone ran. Like I said, it was chaos.
It was self-defense.
Maybe so, maybe so. But doesn't matter. We go down this road, they won't be putting you on trial. They'll be putting your best friend, Emmett. Now, do you have the stomach to watch the sharks rip him apart limb by limb in front of the whole world and leave him destroyed? Canceled. Marcus, you're standing toe to toe with a behemoth and we haven't even begun to fight. College football's more important than you. Me, Emmett, or whatever really is on that phone. The American people will let the state of Missouri fall into the sea rather than give up Saturday afternoon drunk and rowing for their alma mater.
or inevitable as the rain. You gotta put on that helmet or not.
Inevitable. Like what?
The rain.
I'm inevitable as the rain. Feels powerful.
Mm-hmm. It was.
Gonna have to drain the fluid out of this damn thing again.
You look better. Lighter.
Finally breathed through my nose.
By the way, that Doc Holliday head fake, you playing like you were on your deathbed was sure good. Like the nuance of Kilmer, but I bought it.
I'll be a huckleberry.
Sure, they didn't try to use me against you.
No. I swear.
Is it possible now that you
trust me? They know this fire hurts them way more than it hurts us. Those people involved in the cover-up, they ain't doing shit.
Supernova New Orleans is ready to explode with excitement tonight. It's the Snickers National Title Game. Hi, everybody, and good evening. I'm Steve Levy, along with Malcolm Jenkins, and this one has all the makings. This could be a classic.
No.
We're talking about for years to come.
Even.
For a variety of reasons.
A lot of the controversy still looms with LaMarcus James being missing from the action as he continues his fight against the NCAA practices. A stance that has gone crazy on social media with the viral hashtag, fix the system.
How about 1 million tweets the last 12 hours alone? My sense is this is only the beginning. How do you think that translates onto the field the next 60 minutes we'll see tonight?
Well, I think you'll see these coaches have these teams prepared. You know, these players have worked so hard to get to this moment that I think that they'll be focused on the game.
At least we made some noise, right?
Knowing that this is everything that they want.
No, that wasn't just noise. The truth is out now because of us. And they can't hide it. Now more people are going to stand up a lot more. They don't know like where to hit them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Man, we're like the rebels in Rogue One. We die on the beach, but the plans for the Death Star make it off the island.
Nothing is inevitable except the truth.
To toss all your morals aside, piece of the pie, something foreign to drop. What would you put on the line? They say they can guarantee all the money you need if you trade in your soul first. When the money and ego bring out the evil in people, what is your soul worth? Let us pray. Father, forgive them, cause they do not know what they've done. Came from the bottom, the slums, and we got it straight out the mud. Only because the pressure they tried to put on me was never enough. Mama was right when she called me a son of a gun. So you better duck. May heaven forgive you for pressing your luck. Fall for nothing.